I'm talking with Mona Eltahawy, who just gave a wonderful speech on the importance of the arts in the recent revolutions in Egypt and elsewhere in the Middle East. Mona, one of the things you talked about was the Tunisian rapper Balti, who mentioned that rap is the fuel for the revolution. Can you talk a little bit more about the use of music and the arts in the recent revolutions and the ongoing revolutions?
On young people, especially over the past few years, and one of their biggest tools against the regimes has been hip hop. And it's been hip hop in the way that it was meant to be when it was first born in the Bronx. And that is a form of music by the people, for the people, that speaks, gives voice to issues and problems and people that we never hear from. So you have someone like Eltahawy who's been recording and writing secretly off of underground. Secret studio in Tunisia for many years now, and who said during the Tunisian revolution that rap is the fuel of the revolution. And one of his videos has went viral, and I think it's been seen by 350,000 hits on YouTube. And he and many others say that because it's very difficult to get their videos out or get their music out, social media was a way that they use social media to get around censorship and get their music out to the people. Another very famous Tunisian rapper is El General, you know, the general. And El General recorded a song called, one of Balti's songs was Zain al-Abidin Ben Ali and His 40 Thieves. And that's in reference to the now deposed Tunisian dictator, Ben Ali. El General recorded a very famous song that also went viral that was called Dear Mr. President, Your People Are Dying. And when he recorded that song and uploaded it onto YouTube, armed police came to his home and whisked him away, and he was jailed. 8 days later, Ben Ali was forced to step down because of the revolution, and El General was released. And it's a lovely moment where you see the artist replace the dictator, because Ben Ali had to run away from Tunisia, and El General now was free to express himself, and he very quickly recorded a song about the need for the revolution to spread. So he basically said, Egypt, Algeria, Libya, Morocco, now you all deserve to be liberated. And lo and behold, very soon afterwards, Egypt started, Libya started, and other places started. You also have a rapper in Egypt who was called Rami Don Juan, who recorded a now very famous song called I Am Against the Government, where he lists all the terrible things that the regime has done that piss him off. You have a famous Algerian rapper called something Double Can, I can't remember his first name, where he rapped to the president about how young people were just dying to emigrate and couldn't stand living in Algeria anymore. And a Libyan rapper called Ibn Thabit, who to this day links to his rap videos and songs on Twitter. Now you can go online, there's a Libyan website called Enough. It's called Khalas in Arabic, but in English it's Enough. It's Enough Gaddafi. And the people behind this website feel so strongly about rap that they've created a mixtape that you can access on their website that has put together all of these rappers that I'm telling you about now. The Libyan regime so hated this website that it went on and it blocked it for a while, but now it's up again and the mixtape is available now. So you can go on there and listen to all of these songs by these rappers.
That's great. And what's the website called again?
Enough Gaddafi. And the mixtape is called Not Far, and that reference is a reference to how all of those countries in the Middle East and North Africa are A, not far geographically, and not far politically in the kind of regimes that they're rising up against.
Wonderful. Thanks so much. It's a great reminder of what we do as artists and the importance of that. Thanks for taking the time to talk with me.
Thank you, David.